everything surrounding us is in motion, slow or fast. You may say some things don't move, but it's not true. You can say mountains don't move, but mountains are on earth and the earth moves around the sun. So in a way, mountains also move. Everything in this universe moves. And with the help of physics and mathematics, we have always tried to represent these motions in some sort of formulas or laws. And that lets us predict the future. We predict the future because of these equations and formulas. If you know the velocity and angle with which the cannon is firing the projectile, you can guess where it will land because you have projectile motion equations. Look at this billiards table. If we hit the cue ball, stop here. Can you guess where this cue ball will be in next 2 seconds? Of course, it continues straight like this. That prediction was easy. Now let's make things a little complicated, this time with a different setup. Can you guess where this cue ball and all other balls will move? Mathematics can calculate the future positions of all the objects as a function of time. But this time, mathematics is not simple. The number of equations or variables will increase. You have to include friction of the surface, the force, velocity, angle, coefficient of restitution, mass of the balls, etc. Though the number of variables is large, we now have powerful computers that can solve all these equations in seconds and can predict exactly the positions of all the balls even after multiple interactions. If you know the equations which predict the behavior of planets in our solar system, you can determine the positions of planets exactly ahead of time. You can exactly predict the next solar eclipse in India. It's on 10th June 2021. And if this is not enough, there is a website that has list and exact timings of all the eclipses and planet transits that will happen in next 10 years. The Halley's Comet will visit Earth on 20th July 2061. We know that the stars like Betelgeuse will explode for a period of a week. That time it will glow brighter than the full moon in the night sky. It will look almost as if we have 2 moons in the sky for a week. And though the star is 642 light years away from Earth, we know that this is going to happen in next 1 million years. We also know that in next 3.75 billion years, a different galaxy which is 2.5 million light years away from Earth is going to collide with our Milky Way galaxy. And during that period, if humanity still exists, we will see the galaxy in the night sky. But what if I ask about the weather? Tomorrow, will it rain exactly at 3:30 p.m.? We have developed mathematics and science enough to predict these events happening in coming millions and billions of years. But at some things like weather predictions, we fall short. We cannot predict the weather with 100% accuracy. We only are able to predict a probable forecast. We spend a lot on weather predictions. We have over 1,000 satellites orbiting the Earth and constantly monitoring the weather pattern. We have supercomputers solving 200,000 trillion calculations per second. But still, we cannot predict the weather. And the reason is chaos. The weather is a chaotic system. To really understand the chaotic system, we start with a simple pendulum. If you give it a swing, it oscillates. The behavior is pretty straightforward. We have some equations describing the motion of this pendulum. Let's take two such pendulums side by side. We will deflect both pendulums initially. One at 60 degrees, another at slightly more angle, 60.1 degrees. and let's see what happens when you release them. Nothing odd. Though the starting positions of each pendulum is slightly different, there is no major difference in their motion as the time ticks away. And therefore, a simple pendulum is a deterministic system. Now, let's attach another pendulum to the first one. This setup is called a compound pendulum. Though the motion of this pendulum is complex, for this system also we have a set of equations describing the motion. Let's again set these two double pendulums, one at 60 degrees and another at 60.1. When we release these pendulums, for some period, they nicely follow a similar path, but after some time, their path diverges and both pendulums swing in a completely different pattern. Phenomena like this, which are very sensitive to and dependent on the initial condition, are called chaotic systems. Turbulent motion of fluid, motion of air and smoke, the weather, are few examples of such chaotic systems. Let's say you have a set of sensors at some place that are constantly measuring temperature, humidity, air velocity, density, and all other parameters. Now we also have mathematical equations that we can put all these values in and can predict the future weather conditions. What will happen if we change one of the input variables a bit? If that is a deterministic system, the outcome should change slightly, and we should be able to predict future weather with accuracy. But as the weather is a chaotic system, this slight change in the input variable may give a completely different prediction at the end. The conclusion? It's very difficult to predict the future of any chaotic system due to its sensitive dependence on initial condition. If it is impossible to predict the exact future of a chaotic system, then why we have more than 1,000 weather satellites revolving around the Earth? And why we are spending so much money on weather prediction? Even if we cannot predict the exact future of chaotic system, we can predict the future with probability. Let's say we have an active hurricane with strong winds and spiral thunderstorms. It's very important to know the future path of that hurricane. We have satellites constantly monitoring the data. Based on this real-time data, we predict its future path. Now we get different input values. We again predict the future path of travel. We do this several times. And though the system is chaotic, now we have a pattern, and based on that pattern, we can predict the path of the hurricane with probability. And if we have more accurate sensors and systems, we can predict the weather with more accuracy. Weather forecast is very important for us. Weather warnings are important to protect life and property. Predictions of heavy rains, snow, and wind forecasts are used to plan activities around these events and to survive them. Weather forecasts are getting better with advances in technology. 50 years ago, predictions beyond one day ahead were uncertain. But now forecasts out to a week ahead are generally reliable. Along with these things that we discussed, chaos theory is also exceptionally important in other fields like artificial intelligence and quantum computing. It will be exciting to see just how far we can push this theory to help us predict the behavior of chaotic systems and thus predict the future. If you are new here, subscribe to watch more interesting videos. And thanks for watching.